is the coach, welcoming you to Madden Ultimate Team. This is the NFL on EA Sports, between our visitors and the Houston Texans. With that, let's head over to the Space City of Houston, standing by an NRG Stadium. Here are Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis.
Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis on hand. Kickoff just moments away. Charles, quickly, keys to the game.
For me, it's coaching. Who prepared his team the best going into this one to give them the confidence to believe that they would win the game? That's who's going to come out of this one on top.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken at the 3. They will take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. Their franchise quarterback, the one leading them out, back to full health now for his second season out of Clemson. It's Deshaun Watson.
What a start to his NFL career as a rookie. 19 touchdown passes in just 6 starts. Has more touchdowns than Joe Flacco, Tyrod Taylor, or Marcus Mariota. And Houston went 1-8 after losing him, which lent credence to many people saying he should have been the rookie of the year based on his play and how Houston did without him.
Watson on first down. Touchdown now, Watson, and down he goes. Khalil Mack in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
And so much for that great field position to start the game. Now they're way behind the sticks. Can't wait to see what their second down call is going to look like now.
The job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's 2nd and 20. From the gun, here's Watson. Going deep for Hopkins. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that first drive. Pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your bats are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
Robbie Gould on for the extra point. Gould able to tack on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes down to the 25-yard line. Heading out is the Texans offense as they get set to take over here. Watson will bring up the Texans here, 1st and 10, at their own 25-yard line. Here's Watson. Of 11.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Some hot water now after that sack. It's 2nd and 21. Now a first carry for Lamar Miller. And he'll get this one out to about his 14. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Third and long, it's Watson. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. At the end of one, it's a close game here early on. We'll be back with more of Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's Texans football as we get going at corner number two, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. On fourth down, here's the veteran Shane Leckler to punt it away. Now Sanders. Fancy footwork in midfield. A tremendous return there, 39 yards. And this offense are going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. So now you've got their offense coming out for the first time with great initial field position. Bringing them out onto the field, Michael Vick, the all-time leading rusher from the QB position, over 6,100 yards.
Yeah, he averaged 7 yards per carry. Another NFL record for him. How about the nicknames that people gave him? The human joystick, the human cheat code. I'm just telling you, watching him play, I pulled muscles in the booth watching him, thinking about trying to tackle him. He was that type of a player, hard to get on the ground. They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They stay on the ground, but this time it's over. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10.
Upstairs, you might want to file that play away. Did you see how fast the safety closed on that one? Coming up in right support, made a big-time tackle. Might want to try and check into a pass next time.
Got him for a loss. Really, really great play defensively. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. As he'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Up. touchdown. Jimmy Graham in the final seconds of the first half. And his guys are going to add on to their lead.
And that's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook, but even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squid kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point. Goal to add the extra point. Goal with the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. So that drive spanned five plays. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at the three. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. It's a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. And Gold is able to pull it through. So we hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL. And it's a presentation of EA Sports.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one is maybe not exactly in the bag yet, but there is definitely a big mountain to climb in this third quarter. The teams are already back out there, so let's not waste any time, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon God.
Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill. Oh, a spin. Now he brings him over. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Now this offense about ready to take over again. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? And they score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, but you can take the spirit away from the other team.
And he's
going
to go down. The Texans come in. Christian Covington in there to get him for a loss of five.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the third quarter.
Yeah, anytime you go to the lockers with that 2-3-score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
Now a second down throw for Vic. Escaping the pressure run. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. That his first catch so far. They held him under wraps, but he's got a first down there.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurate when he throws a nice pass for a first down.
Under a minute to go in his third quarter as they come up first and 10. First throw now for the backup Mahomes. He's going to let this one go deep. It's caught at the 10. And all the way in for the touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 67 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. And that time. time he came out of the slot for that big play downfield for the score.
I think what we just saw there, partner, is what we call scheming a guy open. Put him in the slot, know that he has tremendous speed. What you're doing with your other receivers is likely running shorter routes to draw the attention closer to the line of scrimmage to give him a chance to get downfield and turn it into a one-on-one route, often against the safety. You like your eyes when he's running against the safety. His speed usually wins, and it did on that play.
Now Gold for the extra point. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded at the two. Take it back only to about the 13-yard line here.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Here's the Texans offense now, readying for their first possession of the second half. This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
Now a first carry for Deontay Foreman, who was lost to the Achilles injury last year. And he finds enough of an opening to get this one back up to his 20. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. Gonna do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Back now in Houston. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. Eventually, they'll be left with a third and two. Third and two, Watson. The hookup on the right side to Hopkins. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. And Sanders now returning. Fast footwork by Sanders. Watson tackles, got room to run. A great return there of 22 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, unfamiliar city, obviously, unfamiliar hotel, no one's going to be with you once you get to the stadium, they're all going to be against you. You name it, all those things they had to deal with, they were able to conquer them and do it convincingly.
Yeah, they did it very convincingly, and now the final moments of this one.
I know the scouting report on him is that he didn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now they're going to throw it here with Vic. Forced out to his left. He gets it left side of Johnson. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Sometimes it's designed and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And that play is able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
I've got a lap here, and I really don't want to because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings
exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
Gold with the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They are down big. They have not scored a single point. I don't know. Are they so defeated at this point you just want to get in the locker room and get the heck out of here?
That is one way to approach it. Sometimes coaches say, that's it, okay? It hasn't worked all game. There's no sense in doing something now. Let's get out of here. No one gets hurt. But others will look at it and say, we still have an opportunity to do something. It's like you have pride on the line, and execution as you look forward and get ready for your next game. And a message to your team, we're not going to quit. No matter what, no matter what the battle is, we're going to finish this thing out.
So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Second down, here's Watson. Now a desperation throw, deep down, a fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30, and his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They'll run with the backup. This is Williams. And will slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down. The storyline in this one, Charles, no doubt the number 0. Zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. And what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that 0 on the scoreboard for them, going along with those 0s in the time column, too?